Over the past 40 years, advances in cancer treatment have made it possible for the majority of pediatric patients in the United States to survive their diagnosis. But for young girls treated before puberty, survival often comes with a hidden cost. Of the roughly 1 in 300 who are diagnosed, many are left unable to grow, begin puberty, or one day have children.
They undergo those treatments, and then when they reach the age of pubertal development, 12, 13, 14, they really don't start puberty. And puberty is key in developmental process.
That challenge sparked a bold idea at Michigan.
My goal is to try and develop an artificial ovary that can be implanted in this patient and really integrate and really maintain this normal physiological function.
That vision wouldn't be possible without years of foundational research in single-cell biology, much of it launched at the University of Michigan. The work began with a $1 million challenge grant from the Michigan Institute for Data and AI in Society, and was later expanded with additional support from U of M's Biosciences Initiative.
In 2019, the committee decided to fund an initiative on single-cell spatial biology and ultimately invested $7 million in that area of research. The goal was to both bring in faculty experts in this new emerging technology and to provide cutting-edge core discovery equipment for all the faculty across Michigan.
Those investments gave then UM geneticist June Lee the tools to lead one of the university's earliest efforts to explore biology one cell at a time.
The key phrase I use to explain is cellular heterogeneity, a complex mixture of many different cells working in concert. But without the ability to analyze them individually, the old technology tend to grind up a million cells, analyze their average gene activity. So single cell technology, it's transformative for researchers who for decades are stymied by not being able to address cellular heterogeneity that's affecting tissue function.
Momentum from Michigan's single cell breakthroughs helped spark new applications, including the Artificial Ovary Project, which soon attracted national attention and external support.
Another push came also funding-wise from the Chan Zuckerberg Foundation. You know, they came up with this idea of creating the cell atlas of all human cells. And we were like, oh, wait a second, what about reproductive systems? So they were excited to give us money to do this because it wasn't available.
But it's thrilling to me to see discoveries being made in real time so quickly after these investments.
Forbes named U of M's artificial ovary work one of five important medical breakthroughs of 2024.
We are close enough to take it to the clinical trial. And once this product goes into the clinical trial and it's successful, you know, the next step is actually giving it to the patients.